رسول الله طال بي الحنين.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The Holy Prophet said, "Ad-Dinu an-Nasiha, religion is sincerity." Qulna liman, we said to whom? The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, replied, "To Allah, His Book, His Messenger, the leaders of the Muslims, and to their common people." This hadith tells us that nasiha, sincerity, is a very important teaching of Islam. Ad-Dinu an-Nasiha, religion is sincerity, means that all the religious teachings focus on one thing, and that is to develop the quality of sincerity amongst the believers. But what does it mean to be sincere? Sincerity can be explained in different ways. We can say that sincerity means that whatever we believe, it should be reflected in our actions. There should be no contradiction what we say and what we do, what we believe and what we practice. They should go in correspondence to each other. That will be called sincerity. If a person believes in Allah and the Messenger of Allah, and he does not give any importance to their commands, so we can say that he is not sincere in his belief in Allah and the Messenger of Allah. So sincerity requires us that we should practice whatever we believe. We can also say that sincerity also means that the intentions behind our actions must be pure. If a person is doing some good deed, like he is doing charitable act, but the purpose is to get fame in the town and to be praised by the other people. If a person is offering his prayer, but the purpose is to show off that he is a very pious person, so obviously we will say that he is not sincere in his a'mal. So sincerity also demands us to be pure in our intentions behind our actions. That's why the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "Innamal a'malu bin niyat," indeed all actions are judged by intentions. And sincerity also means that we should think positively. We should be positive for all other people. Like, if a person thinks for something good for himself and he is thinking for other people in a different way, so we will say that he is insincere person. A sincere person is one who thinks positively for other people in the same way, at the same level as he thinks for himself. So that will be called a sincere person. So these are the teachings of this hadith, that how we can develop the sincerity in ourselves. But how can we practice sincerity in our life? There are different ways for that. First of all, we need to be sincere with Allah, and sincerity with Allah demands us, requires us to believe in all the commands of Allah, give importance to the commands of Allah, and implement them in our life. If a person is saying that I love Allah and Allah is my Rabb and I believe in Him as the one and only God and authority, and all of his actions are going against the commands of Allah, so we will say that he is not sincere. Sincerity towards the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, means that we should follow his sunnah. Our appearance, our behavior towards others, our the qualities in our character, all these things should reflect that we are the true followers of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. That is sincerity with the Messenger of Allah. Just praising Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, once in the whole year and celebrating the Holy Prophet's birthday or something like that, and doing all the things against the sunnah of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, in the entire year, obviously this is not the sincerity with the Messenger of Allah. Sincerity towards the Prophet also requires us that the people who hate him, who make fun of him, we should boycott them. And then sincerity towards the Holy Quran means that we should have a strong relationship with the Holy Quran on a regular basis. We should recite them, we should recite the Holy Quran regularly, and we should try to understand the meaning of the Holy Quran by attending the gatherings of ulama. Then we should try to implement it as much as possible in our life. That is sincerity with the Quran, not just reading it and doing all the things in life against the teachings of the Quran. Obviously, that will not be the sincerity with the book. And sincerity with the rulers means that we should not do any rebellion against our rulers if they are leading us according to the Quran and Sunnah. But if they are going against the Quran and Sunnah, so we should inform them about their mistake. And if they will not correct themselves even after knowing it, Only then we are allowed to take some action against them and come out against the government and protest. Otherwise, if they are doing good, so we should be cooperative with them. When Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an became the caliph, so he said in his first official speech that I am appointed as your caliph, but I am not better than you. If I am right, so help me in it, and if I am wrong, then set me right. So this is called sincerity towards the rulers. And sincerity towards the common people is that we should not do any such activity which causes inconvenience for the people around us. And there are many examples for that. It means that you are parking the car in a wrong place just to save your 2 minutes, but you don't think that the other people will be, obviously the traffic will be stuck over there, and many of the people will be teased by your this small action. So it means that you are not sincere. You are thinking only for your 2 minutes and you have no care of others' precious time. So sincerity with the common people means that before doing every action, we should take care that it is not a source of harm for any other person. And whenever we can do something for the betterment of our community, for the benefit of our community, we should do this. Only then we will be called a sincere believer, a sincere member of the community. So we should try to follow all these teachings of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, to make our own life better and our communal life better. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Allah.